Hi everyone, it's Inga Hart, the Balanced Foodologist. Welcome to an extra episode of Food is the Gateway, because I already went live this morning in my group, Food is the Gateway. So if you guys want to know about the connection between detox, getting rid of clutter, and putting your money where your mouth is, join that group, because you'll get to know more about that topic. But I know you always want to know, how do I keep my food interesting? Well, one of the things I do, you all know that I also use deliveries. That bird is loud, right? We live in the tropics. What I always do, you guys know that, is that I use delivery services to get my food here. So I have Islands Organic coming here, I have Club Sahat coming here, my water is delivered at the house, and also my help, she does grocery shopping for me as well. But I also still go to the shops myself. Why? Because there's always new things to be found in the shops, right? And also I find it very important to keep that connection to my food myself. So what did I do today? I'm just going to show you snacks for the kids. So seaweed. Seaweed to make sushi for ourselves. Then I bought, I found these nice little plastic boxes. You guys know I love to use them for the snacks for the kids and the lunches, just to put some peanut butter or jam in there. Or I use this for snack as well. It's cashew with some cacao around it. So the kids will just get a few in a box like this in their snack box. So I bought some gomasio with spirulina. You can also make it yourself, but I just wanted to be easy this time on myself, because I have to prepare a lot of stuff for this afternoon. And we sprinkle this on our rice to give it a different flavor. So in that way, I make my rice more interesting and give it that extra flavor, different flavor that you want. Then I bought some fennel. Finally, I found it. This fennel, I use it to make a digestive tea. I'm also going to teach that this afternoon to a client of mine. I'm going to teach her to how to make ghee, how to make kishri, and a digestive tea. So it's like this, you know, three things that will make a beautiful medicinal meal that is really good for your digestion and gives it a break. You can eat it two, three, or more times a week, what you want. And I'm actually going to make a small series about that, so very soon I will be doing it with you as well. So this is new for me. I went into this shop and I just looked at what they all had, and you guys know that I eat gluten-free, so they have these nice, I don't know if they're nice, I hope they're nice, cookies. They're made out of rice flour, so we're going to have that probably today or tomorrow. I'll give it to the kids in their snack box. Raw peanut brittle and some sweet rice crackers. So you see, guys, all snacks for the children to school, a way to make their rice more interesting. They love this. And then I bought my rice crackers, flaxseed crackers, sorry, that I always love. This is also something that goes in the lunch boxes of the kids, and something I have as a snack. Then here I have mung beans. So I'm going to soak them for the kishri I'm going to make. This is ripe rice, also for the kishri. And I finally found buckwheat flour, so I can make some nice hazelnut tarts with Thijs this weekend. He doesn't know yet that I want to do that with him, but I am going to do that with him. What did I buy here? Oh, this is part of lunch, guys. So this, I bought this at my day, banana flour. And so it hit, one is with spinach potato, and the other one is with Thai veggies. So we're going to eat that with a salad and a soup. And then I bought this huge pack of banana flour pancake mix, and I'm going to try this one out also this weekend. The recipe here is with dairy, so I'm going to try and find out how I can make this work dairy free. And well, I'm pretty excited about that as well, because that's going to be part of another video series that I'm going to create for you guys. But this was just for you to give you an idea on, oh, and the ghee. I'm going to make ghee. So this is the unsalted butter, and I actually left the basmati rice in the scooter. I now have remembered, so I have to get that. So I hope this was an inspiring look into my shopping bags and what I got this morning. And you know, this is a fun excursion. I do this like maybe once every 3 weeks. I really go to the shop and look what's new, and I ask all kinds of questions. So for instance, I found out we now have the first vegan Bali Wagyu, and we're probably going there this weekend, so I'm excited about that. And okay, and this is also new and exciting. So a lot to do in the weekend. Always try your new stuff out in the weekend, and always remember that food is the gateway to living an energetic and fulfilling life.